Hello and welcome to another video. Today we got an B350 Gaming Plus board from MSI. This is an AM4 socket board. This came to me from a customer that wanted to update his BIOS and the PC crashed or turned off for whatever reason, and after that it wouldn't post anymore. Right now we got our post card in there, we got one post card in there, we got a CPU in there. We have debug LEDs right here. The very first one is the CPU debug LED. I'm going to turn the power supply on. I'm going to hit the button that is right here at the bottom. And as you can see, we get D0 on that post. We get 00 on that post with PCIe reset being applied all the time. And on the bottom, on the right, see the very first CPU, the very first LED, which means CPU is missing. On the power supply, we have 1.7 amps static. CPU is getting a little bit warm, but nothing hot, which means the board is not initializing, not seeing the CPU, not going to through any boot sequence. So we're going to turn it off again. Now the board is off. The first thing you would want to do now is to remove the CMOS battery, short the two contacts while your power supply is off, and see if you can reset the BIOS like that and hit the switch a couple of times, the on switch right there, so that you're sure that the 3VSB is turned, is completely drained, and you would want to try to reset the BIOS like that. If that doesn't work, the next thing you're going to look at is if you have a button at the I/O somewhere. Because some boards have a function where you can plug a USB stick with the BIOS on it into the sides, and then you can just hit the button and you have an automatic flashing of the BIOS. That even that can get corrupted if the BIOS is in a state like this one, so that is not an always guarantee that the BIOS has been programmed correctly. None of these features are available on this board, so today I'm going to show you how I fix that BIOSes, how I remove the chip, program it, and put it back on. And on this chip it's very easy. You can see our BIOS chip is right this one. MSI has it very often that it has these pin header with the BIOS chip near to it, and I want to show you one other thing that I sometimes do with this pin header to flash the board. For that we need the schematics, and right now you can see our board view. This is a little bit of a different board, but this is an MSI board as well, which has an SPI, which in this case is our BIOS chip, and the JSP1. This is our header that I showed you before, and what I've done before is, as you can see, if I click on the very first pin, this pin is connected to this resistor, a 0 ohm one, and going to the pin header, which means this first pin is directly connected with the fifth one here. And like that, you can go through all of the pins of the third and fourth one and go through all of these, and you see that with this header, you can directly program the SPI. This is what I've done this a couple of times, and it actually does work, but I sadly do not have the right cables to hook up to it, because the pins are some smaller size than the default Arduino one cables that we would plug onto these. But you could theoretically could make like a TPM header that directly plugs into this and then adapts to your BIOS programmer, and you could like that program the chip without soldering to the board at any point. But that's not what we're going to do today. Today I'm going to show you how I unsolder the chip and flash it with the flasher, where you solder the chip onto the flasher itself. Right now we can see our BIOS chip. Important when you look at your BIOS chip is to know what kind of chip you have. This is a 250128FW. S0. The important one is the FW at the end. This is what we're going to need later when we pick the chip we want to program for our programmer, so it knows what kind of chip we are programming. And another thing that you need to look at is all these small resistors right here. and at the top, that you're not going to lose any of them. Because that sometimes happens that people knock off some of the resistors and then their board doesn't work anymore because it can't access the BIOS. So have a good look at where you have resistors and capacitors so you don't lose them. And also make sure you know where pin 1 is orientated. For our sake here, it's bottom right. Right now, first thing I do to get the chip off is to wet the joints. So I'm taking my soldering iron right here and I'm going to apply some leaded solder to every pin. It doesn't have to look great or anything, there just has to be some leaded solder onto them. And we're to lower the melting point of the pins. It doesn't even matter if they're bridged like that, because we just want solder onto them. And what we're now going to do is, now I got my tweezers, now I'm going to take my hot air station, which is set to 400 degrees right now, 40% airflow. And right now, we're going to remove the chip. Just going to use hot air. We don't even need flux or anything because there's already some flux in the leaded solder that I use. As you can see, the joints are really wet. And now we're going to heat this up. Be careful not to point the heat at the connector at the top, and it's already out. And right now, we got our BIOS programmer here. Most of you who've seen some videos already do know this thing. This thing's very cheap, CH341A, the programmer here. And what we're going to do, as you can see, I use these pads a lot. We're going to solder the chip right onto those pads so we can use it in this jig right here. I went ahead and had a look at our board view. I got the exact board view for this board now, for our B350 Gaming Plus. Watch for the SPI chip, our BIOS chip. And I looked at pin 8, which you can see is called CPU underscore 1P8, which means this chip is actually in 1.8 volt chip. And I almost did the mistake of not checking that. Because if I would have directly soldered this chip onto our BIOS programmer on the backside, as I showed you, we would have not gotten a good dump onto the chip and we would have not been successful. So it's very important to check the chip for what voltage you need. You can either check the schematic, as I did here, or you can probe the pin on the board and see what kind of voltage it uses. And in the following, you're going to see me how we're going to use the 1.8 volt adapter to flash this chip. Right now, we're soldering our chip onto our small little adapter board. Make sure that the dot is where pin 1 is. We're using hot air for that. And now we have a small little bridge that we're going to take out with our soldering iron. Now we're going to build our package up. As you can see, pin 1 is marked right there. And pin 1 is also marked in the top left. Now you're going to orientate your programmer. You have pin 1 in the top left, as you can see right there. I'm going to use this. I'm going to plug it into there so that pin 1 is in the top left. I'm going to close this up. Now, next thing is we're going to do is to see that pin 1. And we're going to look in our programmer. And as you can see on our programmer, on that side on the left, you can see 25XX, which is what we have. And you see the dot in the top right corner, which means that one is pin 1. So the fourth one from the bottom here is our pin 1, which means we take our programmer, we have pin 1, and it should go in like this. So this is what you can see now. This is it plugged in. We're going to close it up. And now we have one board here. This is the 1.8 volt adapter plugged into my tool. And this thing, this whole sandwich board, we're now just going to plug into our computer, and I will see you on the computer. Right now we got our device plugged in, and this is the support site for the Beef 350 Gaming Plus, and we're just going to download this very first BIOS. And I already got it downloaded right here. We got two files, one TXT, which we don't care about, and this is the file for the BIOS that we're going to flash. And next up, I want to open our programmer app. Now you can see our programmer app, which is Neo Programmer 2.2.0.10. And first thing what we're going to do is we're going to detect the IC. And as we can see, it throws out the exact device that we had before that we saw. This is not always the case. Sometimes it has multiple in the list, but this time it saw it directly. And as you can see, it shows it's a 1.8 volt chip. This is important. So you're going to select the chip now. What we're now going to do first is we're going to read the IC, which is this one. And now we're going to wait until it's done reading. Now our chip has been read. And what we're now going to do is, normally I would now save this data, which you do by save file and then saving the data as a backup BIOS. But because I know that this BIOS is junk anyways, I'm directly going to go to the next step, which is to erase the IC. So we're going to erase it. And yet again, we're going to wait until this is finished. And now our erasing has been successful, like you can see in the bottom right here. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to open a file. We are going to go to our schematics folder where I saved it. Software, board view, schematics, B350, this one. And what we're going to do is point at all files. And we're going to pick up this file that we downloaded from the MSI site. We're going to open it up. It is opened up. You want have write and verify selected here. And then you're going to program and start programming. And now we're going to wait yet again. Now you can see programming memory and verifying main memory has been successful. What we're now going to do, we're going to close everything and pull out our adapter from the computer. Now we are back at our bench setup with our sandwich board. What we're now going to do is we're going to unsolder this chip from here with hot air again, and we're going to solder it back onto its spot on the main board. Now we're putting our chip back on with hot air, as you can see, pointing the dot on the chip onto the bottom right as we had before to mark pin 1. Our joints are still pretty wet from the leaded solder. The chip almost moves into the spot by itself. We're going to remove the short that we created right there. Going to add some leaded solder again to make sure that the contacts are good. Now we're going to clean up all the residential flux from the solder using a toothbrush and some cotton swipes, and as you can see with the IPA, it evaporates very quick and looks great. And right now, our board is all done. The joints really don't look that great, but it works. Nothing is joined up, I mean, no pins are shorted together. And as you can see, we still have our first pin in the bottom right, as we had before, indicated by the dot. And the plastic is not melted, as you can see at the top, even though we used 400 degrees and hot air. It's still good because we used the leaded solder for the joints, which made the melting point way lower. And now I'm going to get the board set up and we're going to see if that actually fixed our problem. Our board is fully set up now. We have a 3000G in here, which is an APU, which is why we have DVI connected at the top left. We have our postcard right here, right there, our white postcard. And we have power connected, And in the bottom right, you can see the power supply. And in the top right, you can see the pulse screen. So what we're now going to do, we're going to hit the button on our power supply. And now I need something to short the pins. And I'm pressing the power button now. And as we can see, we have way higher amperage already on our power supply. And the pulse codes are already running through. And we have AF on our card, on our pulse card. The current looks very good. It's jumping around, which we would expect. It's probably boot looping right now a few times because there's been a new CPU inserted and we have different RAM in here. You can see the pulsed LEDs are running through. Our current still looks very good. We should now be at our display output. Let's check if we got the right screen for you in the top right. Might be a wrong one. I'm going to quickly double check with my screen, but we should be posting right now, but we have no signal, which is kind of weird because our post card is on AF right now and our post LEDs are on VG after VGA are on boot. The very last one is supposed to be for boot. I guess the CPU is very hot as well. It should be at least. My cables are all connected. I'm going to once more go over my connections and I'm going to see you again after that. But I'm pretty sure we're already posting. There's just some issue with my capturing, I think. One moment, please. So, for some reason, I can't get a picture out of the DVI of the APU. I got now our trusty old RX 460 that we fixed in a previous episode here to post. We have DVI connected to there. Going to turn on the power supply. You can see almost 4 amps. Going to watch that. Over 4 amps, 5 amps. That looks very good. Just like the normal boot sequence. As you can see, the power LEDs are also cycling. We're now waiting for a picture, and there's our picture. We have the BIOS, which means this board is fixed. All it took was to reprogram the BIOS. So a stuck CPU LED with 00 on the post codes can also be a dead BIOS or the boot sequence not being initialized. And this was a very easy fix with a chip off of even a 1.8 volt chip. So I was even able to show you the adapter plate for that. And now the board can go all back together. Don't really know why the APU wasn't posting through DVI, but the board is fixed. This is all I need. The GPU is being initialized and recognized and giving us a picture. I'm going to run a few tests because of the USB and the SATA to make sure it all works, but I think we're pretty good. I don't think there's going to be any more problem with that. As you can see, as an example, with the single stick of RAM and 75 watt GPU, we're already drawing close to 6 amps. So just for reference, so that you know what amperage could be normal and with this makeshift cooler. Thank you very much for watching. Subscribe if you liked the video. Like the video if you liked it, so you can catch some more of my videos. And I will see you in the next one. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.